Let's embark on a virtual adventure through a captivating landscape, a land where tall rock pillars, resembling ancient stone guardians crowned with little stone hats, rise majestically from the ground. Welcome to the bizarre land of Hoodoos in Canada. These geological sculptures were shaped over millions of years, and they are part of Alberta's Badlands.
But the Hoodoos are so much more than just some cool-looking rocks. They tell a geological story of chemistry and survival against the forces of nature while being deeply rooted in the cultural heritage of the Indigenous people.
Today, we will learn what the Hoodoos are, how they were formed, what led to their unique shapes, and we will explore their cultural significance. So let's head into Alberta's Badlands and explore the science and cultural heritage of these fairy chimneys.
Hello and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, I'm Maria and I'm a scientist who loves nature and cultural heritage. In this channel, we're having fun exploring together the many wonders of our planet. Today's video is inspired by my recent move to Canada and my desire to explore the many amazing wonders of this beautiful country. So welcome to the first episode of Canada's Wonders. And we'll start by exploring the Hoodoos in Alberta's Badlands. While we usually focus on the geology and cultural heritage of a single site per video, today we'll be looking at two sites, both in Alberta's Badlands, both shaped by similar forces, but with very different origins and cultural heritage significance. Let's start by exploring what the Alberta Hoodoos have in common, the fascinating geological features of the Hoodoos.
But first, we need to understand exactly what Hoodoos are. Rising from the floors of arid drainage basins and badlands, Hoodoos are striking examples of rock erosion. Hoodoos are characterized by their tall, narrow, spire-like rock formations that often exhibit fascinating and unique features. Known under various names, including fairy chimneys, tent rocks, and earth pyramids, these remarkable geological formations are found in arid regions throughout the world, some of them being in the province of Alberta, Canada.
Alberta's Badlands are home to Hoodoos spread across a very large area, and today we'll be exploring two iconic locations, the Drumheller Hoodoos and those at Writing-on-Stone Provincial Park.
Now, let's see how the Hoodoos are formed. The process of Hoodoo formation generally starts with a wide plateau composed of relatively soft rocks that are then covered by a layer of harder, more erosion-resistant rocks. Over time, various weathering conditions such as wind, rain, and low temperatures lead to the erosion of the soft rock. Carbonic acid, produced when rainwater combines with carbon dioxide, creates cracks in the upper rock layers. Water can then trickle down these cracks, amplifying the erosion process of both the upper layers and the softer layers beneath. Eventually, only a small hard rock cap remains on top of a thin column of softer rock, giving them their unique mushroom-like shape. But even this formation will not maintain their current shapes, as erosion is constantly reshaping the columns.
Now, let's see specifically how the Drumheller Hoodoos and the Hoodoos at Writing-on-Stone were formed.
The Drumheller Hoodoos started forming 70 to 75 million years ago, when layers of sediment were gradually deposited in the area. They have a soft base that is made of dark brown marine shale, while the main ingredients of the pillar and cap rocks are sand and clay. A high calcite cement content of 40% of the cap rocks contributes to their higher resistance to erosion.
The Drumheller Hoodoos are eroding at a rate of 1 centimeter per year. This is faster than the erosion rate of any other geological structure. This process will eventually end with the collapse of the columns.
The formation of the Hoodoos at Writing-on-Stone began about 85 million years ago, when layers of sedimentary rock started accumulating at the edge of a vast inland sea. After the last ice age, powerful, heavy flows of meltwater carved through the soft sandstone, sculpting the unique Hoodoos we see today. While some of the writing-on-stone hoodoos are capped with a harder layer of rock, their mushroom shape is less dramatic than the white-capped hoodoos of Drumheller.
The hoodoos at Writing-on-Stone, similar to those at Drumheller, are constantly being reshaped and eroded by the persistent long-term effects of wind and water, processes that continue to alter their appearance over time. While here we're focusing on the hoodoos in Alberta, it's important to note that these geological wonders can be found in various other regions across the globe, including the following sites.
Cappadocia's famous fairy chimneys made of volcanic tuff have been carved over centuries into homes, churches, monasteries, castles, and even entire cities. Erosion of volcanic rock in Serbia created the fascinating site at Djavolja Varoš, Devil's Town, featuring 202 hoodoo rock formations, many crowned by protective boulders. The Bryce Canyon National Park in Utah houses a vast array of red, orange, and white rock spires, forming the world's largest hoodoo concentration.
Have you visited any of these sites? You should definitely visit the ones in Alberta, as hoodoos are just one of the many stunning natural wonders this breathtaking province has to offer.
Alberta is home to pristine lakes that perfectly mirror the majestic Rocky Mountains, lush forests filled with a diverse array of wildlife, and expansive prairies stretching as far as the eye can see, all waiting for you to explore them.
Can you tell how excited I am about living in Canada? So many amazing places to explore, and I'm inviting you to come explore Canada's beauties as well. Okay, so now that we understand the science behind the formation and the shape of the hoodoos, let's explore their cultural significance to understand how these geological marvels have been incorporated in the cultural heritage of the Indigenous communities. But before moving to cultural heritage, if you're enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos about the wonders of our planet.
When it comes to cultural heritage, the Drumheller hoodoos are valued more for their natural beauty. Their heritage significance comes from their unique geology and striking appearance, being recognizable symbols of Alberta's Badlands with high aesthetic, scientific, and historical value. Writing-on-Stone is one of Alberta's 6 UNESCO World Heritage Sites, celebrated for its unique cultural heritage.
If you want to learn more about UNESCO and cultural heritage, I have this other video that's dedicated entirely to cultural heritage.
Writing-on-Stone, or Asinapi, which is the Blackfoot word for it is pictured, it is written, is one of the most important sacred places of the Blackfoot people. The Blackfoot Nation is a confederation of closely connected indigenous groups inhabiting the northwestern plains of North America, across southern Alberta and Saskatchewan in Canada, as well as northern Montana in the US.
Their rich cultural heritage is preserved through ceremonies, oral traditions, and a strong connection to their ancestral lands.
In the cultural landscape of Writing-on-Stone, the hoodoos stand in a landscape abundant with indigenous rock art, some of these dating back to 4,500 years ago. The hoodoos here serve as silent witnesses to the sacred messages and traditions that are integral to the Blackfoot cultural heritage. Because the site has been recognized for its outstanding universal value, it preserves both its tangible and intangible heritage, safeguarding a rich legacy from the ancestors of these lands. Thus, the thousands of engravings and rock paintings, as well as the messages they contain, continue to thrive, making it possible for future generations to also appreciate and learn from them. This area is protected from development by Alberta's Provincial Parks Act, ensuring the respectful access and conservation of the land.
The continued preservation of every culture's heritage is essential for each culture, and their unique traditions enrich our shared global heritage, highlighting our shared humanity on this planet. If you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy this other video about the geology and cultural heritage of another wonder of our planet, the Devil's Marbles in Australia. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!